Hey everybody, welcome back to the Champions for Christ Christian Church book work. Whereas if you work the book will work for you. I'm Dr. Darryl L. Jones, and I'm the senior pastor of Champions for Christ Christian Church, and I praise God, from whom all blessings flow, for allowing me to serve as the pastor to some of the greatest people you would ever want to meet. And today, I want to talk about when we choose the wrong friend. You know, this week we're celebrating what's called Passion Week, which is the last week that Jesus the Christ walked the face of the earth. And in doing so, several events happened. And on this particular day that we celebrate during this week, this is the day that Jesus was betrayed by Judas. And it just left me with a lot of questions and a lot of thoughts. How many of you have chosen a friend before only to be betrayed by that friend? You know, you might have shared fellowship with each other. You might have went to the same schools. You might have participated in the same organizations. You might have even been on a praise team together. You might even sat in the pulpit as fellow ministers of the gospel together. And you might have even had friends that you shared with your family. They might became almost as close to you as family. And then you find out that you were betrayed by your friend. That's a hurting feeling. And you know, especially when you put your trust and your hope in someone, you share your secrets with them, and you just feel as though that you two were just bought together by God. Or maybe you might not have felt that you was bought together by God, but for some reason you were meant to be together as friends, and that person betrayed you. Now, imagine what happened to Jesus. Here he is. He's picked 12 people to be his disciples. He taught them, he trained them on the ways of God. He showed them what it would be like in heaven. He talked about what it's like here on earth. He talked about how you could overcome problems. He taught his friends a lot of things. And just like some of us, we share things with our friends. We teach them things about us. We teach them things about our families. We teach them things about what's close to us, what's important to us. And when they betray you, that hurts. So imagine Jesus feeling just like we feel. They said, the Bible said he's divine and human, so we know he felt hurt. What do you do when you're hurt by someone close to you? You have to still love them. And you have to understand, just like Judas was a part of God's plan for redemption of all of us who love the Lord and serve Jesus and let Jesus be our Lord and Savior, we too have to realize that our enemies are a part of God's plan for our life. That might not sound like good news to you all, but that is really good news. And the story of Judas is found in Matthew, the 26th chapter, and it's the first 16 verses of that in particular. What was interesting is the story of Judas tells about how Judas went to the leaders and asked them about betraying Jesus. They didn't come to Judas. So how many of you know that there are friends in your life who would go to your enemies, or they would go and get you in trouble without trouble coming to them asking for you? And yet it's all a part of God's great plan. So we as Christians, we have to learn to not be so hard when we've been betrayed. We have to learn that that friend that we thought was a friend, and I love this new word that we have called frenemy. That person who we thought was a friend, when that person betrays you and even presents themselves as an enemy to you, you have to realize, and we have to realize, that it's all a part of God's great plan. And sometimes it might not feel good. Sometimes it might cause us pain. It might cause us discomfort. And sometimes we might react in ways that we shouldn't react. But remember, for those of us who walk with the Lord, who talk with the Lord, who are saved and who wants to be able to do the things that Jesus commanded that we would do in serving him, we have to forgive. Forgive that enemy. Forgive that person who told on you. Forgive that person who stole from you. Forgive that person who took from you. Because it's all a part of God's great plan. Now we have to realize one last thing. Unlike Jesus, we don't know everything. But in Jesus' case with Judas, and with Jesus' case in everything in life, Jesus knew everything. Jesus knew who Judas was before Judas was. Jesus knew that Judas would betray him when he took dinner with him, when he went to weddings with him, when he walked the face of the earth with him. Jesus knew it all. So just like Jesus knew about Judas, Jesus knows about your enemy. He knows about that friend that you have who has either put a knife in your back or will put a knife in your back. Jesus knows all. So when you feel as though you have been betrayed, when you feel as though you have hurt someone or have been hurt by someone, give it to Jesus and let Jesus fix it. Let Jesus handle it. Let Jesus know all about your problems. And I promise you, when you give it to Jesus and let Jesus have it, everything will be all right. Thank you so much for tuning in to the Champions for Christ Christian Church Bookwork. As we get ready to celebrate Good Friday, as we get ready to celebrate the Resurrection Day coming up this Sunday, let us all be mindful. Let us all be mindful that God loves us so much that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. I thank God for the eternal gift of life that he's given me, and I thank God for the eternal gift of life that he's given you. Choose wisely. Choose the Lord. Choose ye this day who you will serve, because as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Thank you so much, and until we're together again, we are champions for Christ. Peace.